Yeah, hold on a sec, though.
Because this light is pointing out that way. Yeah, it was in our face yesterday. Because it's a shadow right over my... I'm going to fix it, but I don't know if I can go there.
No, you're good.
I can't reach that.
It's good. Lighting's good.
It's good?
Sounds good.
I don't know, some of this window. See that light in my face?
Oh, the crack from the door.
Yeah. Right? No, that.
Oh, the window.
Yeah. It's like the sunshine. See that coming off that car window on my face?
I got you.
All right. There we go.
There we go.
Yeah, now we ready to talk to the dead. We ready for a seance. Grandma, are you here? Give me a sign. Get your hand off, boy, in the house. Grandma, I told him, Grandma.
That's my grandmama.
Get your head up in the house, young man. She said, "Yo, no, I'm not a stripper." I said, "Well, let's play it by ear. You might not be now, but when you leave here, you might go straight to work.
You might be converted.
You never know what you're capable of.
You never know what and God's going to do in your
on
life.
The Tony Roberts, Lance Woods podcast. You never know how it's going to turn out. So we'll see. I like your tat.
Thank you.
That's dope. Look at mine. I just, this ain't, this is new. Yep. Threw up in my mouth and everything. This shit hurt so bad.
He didn't wash it off yet.
I blacked out. Came to, he's still doing it. He didn't give a shit. He got 5-6 after, you can't see him back.
Can't find him. Hey, look.
Let me see this one. Yeah. It's still there.
You smell it? It's a scratch stick.
It's scratch. Smell like a homeless man's foot. Homeless feet.
Homeless socks. Just the sock.
I don't smell like an earring back. You know that crust in the back? You ever smell one of them shit? Hey, what's up? Welcome to another episode of The Other Truth. Tony Roberts, my partner in crime, Lance Woods. We here again.
Yo, yo.
What's happening today, man?
Don't. This is what happened today. You seen Donald Trump just said that he believes that Obama funded ISIS.
I think Donald Trump is really Mexican, and they kicked him out of Mexico. So he's just a buffoon. I think his mouse is not on the wheel. I'm getting so sick of him. I can't wait this election over with. He has to lose to shut him up. Just, it's over with, man. I'm so tired. I don't know the dude no more. I don't even look at the news no more because he on it all the time.
All the time.
I seen his hair sneeze. I swear to God, I think his hair, he was talking to his hair, just, it did this. By itself. So he thinks Obama got something to do with ISIS.
He said he funded it. He put the money up
for ISIS. Well, you know, he got to say that, man. He got to keep his followers going. He got to keep the excitement and everything because he know that's not true.
That's what happened. Everybody got Obama phones. Obama gave Obama phones to all the ISIS.
You know, you be making that shit up on the way. You didn't read that. I know you goddamn well you didn't read that.
I didn't read that, but how else did he fund it? How else did he have them all in contact?
Because he gave Obamacare. Obama. But everybody entitled to Obamacare. ISIS, don't matter. They terrorists, but they still got health plans. What if they blow up? Their family got to be taken care of. I can't believe, I don't understand how you get the job and you get a room full of people and they go, "We need somebody to take the bomb and blow themselves on the plane full of people. Who we got?" I can't believe somebody go, "I'm him." Who the fuck is that guy? I mean, you didn't have any goals in life. But and if you get picked, shouldn't you be the guy say, "Whoa, whoa, whoa, hell no. Who the fuck put you in charge? Why don't you go?"
That'd be my first question. Why don't you go?
Why don't you go? It's your idea.
Why don't you go do it?
Why not put the thing on the plane and I leave? He said it wouldn't be right. We got to let them know we're willing to die for this. What guy would say that? And they think, this is what they believe. If you kill yourself for the cause, you blow up, whatever, yeah. Poison, whatever. In the other life, you get 72 virgins.
I only want 72 virgins.
I don't want 72 bitches don't know what they're doing. Tell you the truth.
That's what I'm talking about.
That'd be too much work. You ever travel one virgin? You'd be like, Jesus. This is what they all do. You got to do this.
I need.
Right? So now you got to show a video. To prove that this go in this hole, you got a bunch of holes I can put this in. I need you. She said, "What about your holes?" Now you're stepping over the line, bitch. You're stepping out your boundary. Get back in the gate, bitch.
My holes is all exits.
All exits.
Nothing go in.
So, you get 72 virgins. Okay. That's what this guy thinks he's going to get at another. That's what they believe. I mean, this is your belief. You can, you know, blow yourself up. But yeah. What if all the virgins are men?
You don't, they don't know. They don't specify.
They don't. You get there. Brand new, 72 brand new dicks waiting on you.
You were saying,
untouched.
You were saying quick.
Uncircumcised. You got 72 hoodies. You mad as hell. You done blew yourself up.
To a soggy party.
I ain't gonna take it in the face. Forever. You don't know what it takes to get through 72 fresh dicks.
I don't. I have no idea.
You done blew yourself up. That's what I'm telling you. If you listen to this podcast, I'm sure it's gonna be worldwide. We worldwide, all right? If you happen to be a terrorist. just think about your options, man. You can just stay here and,
if I
and go to Six Flags. Or go, you know, get yourself, you got good movies out.
Yeah.
Get yourself a paper route, something, but you ain't got to do this for those 72 virgins. You don't never seen it. Well, they all ugly. Well, they all look like Danny Glover. All the women, all the virgins look like Danny Glover. I think Danny Glover and Wendy Williams are the same person. I don't know why people don't believe that.
Have you ever seen Danny Glover on the Wendy Williams show?
You never see them together.
You will never see it.
I think Tom Hanks and Hillary Clinton are the same person.
They are the same person.
The bitch played in Castaway. I know she did. She running for office. You don't believe me? Throw a volleyball in front of her. I bet she yelled out, Wilson! I'm sorry, Wilson! Hillary Clinton, I mean, I think she should be president. She handsome. But I think she can. I think she should run America. She got the experience. Donald Trump would run it like a TV show.
You ready
like
for,
a business.
You ready for Bill Clinton to be the first lady?
That's no, Caitlyn Jenner. Caitlyn Jenner. I'm talking about.
If you thought Bill was
Caitlyn Jenner won Woman of the Year with balls.
Yeah, she was a woman for like 20 minutes.
All he had was titties, but he still had his package and won Woman of the Year. That's how America. That's how crazy America is. So I don't doubt Donald Trump was leading. Was losing to Hillary in Florida, the votes in Florida only by 2 points. I seen that this morning. And that's scary. 2 points is nothing. You can come back from that. So somebody like this guy. I don't know who. The terrorists? Blind people?
The Mexicans?
Yeah. Well, no. They can't stand it. What I'm saying is, what if he get in? How would this? Come on.
You said you're moving if he get in, right?
I'm going to Canada. I got visas for my family. We're going to move to Toronto or Edmonton or something. But I'm not going to stay here.
Yeah.
Hell no. Nah.
I'm leaving America too.
Because he's going to make it mandatory that everybody have 2 days.
I'll probably move to Fresno.
Yeah, he not going to mess with Fresno. Fresno terrible. Yeah. I've seen somebody in Fresno sit on a porch with no house behind him. Fresno's terrible. Go to Fresno. Everything. Ain't no terrorists coming to Fresno. Yeah, everything already terrible. They went right past Detroit. I'm from Detroit. Terrorists go, oh, somebody beat us to it. Somebody beat us to it.
They've already got it.
Say it again?
They've already got it.
I'm bad at impression. That was a good one. So what was you from? What was that from? Like that Iran or?
I don't know.
ISIS? Was that ISIS?
I have no idea.
But that was a good impression. I mean, what's your terrorist name?
Oh, my terrorist name is
Consentite.
How?
Bless you.
How? Get the bomb.
Get the bomb.
Get the
That's
bomb.
Your last name. Get the bomb.
That's what, Mister.
Get the bomb.
Get the bomb.
That's funny.
That's my name.
You can put that on stage. I mean, get some pissed off people.
But if I really got a bomb, then just tell me fuck that.
I just don't understand. How can you volunteer to blow yourself up?
I like myself too much.
I don't volunteer to take out the garbage. You know, black people ain't gonna be no terror. We ain't on time for shit. If shit to blow up while we in the car, I know man's get stuck in traffic with the bomb and don't throw the bitch out.
I can't blow myself up. What would the streets do without me? Snapchat, follow me, sexual.
You'll blow up getting your boarding pass. And your ass late. So we ain't never had nothing done. That's what we ain't. So, today is going to be a good day.
It's going to be a glorious day.
We're one of our wildest ones. We have a few wild ones, right? But this is going to be a good one right here. This is going to be, for all you for you guys out here, just henpecked with the wife. Because a lot of people, I've been my wife, 9.5 years now. Mm-hmm. I proposed to my wife on Yard Crashers. We were on Yard Crashers. You remember that episode? Mm-hmm. And I proposed to her. They see me on YouTube, and I did a pilot for them. And they said, in return, we're going to send you to Lowe's and go find your family and just do your yard. And they did like 8 weeks of work in 2 days. It worked us to death. And I proposed to my wife. And we got a good love life. I mean, we've been married almost five years. Got a house full of kids, dogs, cars, house, the career. She's my road manager. She's with me all the time. She take care of all my business. Then my agent in Hollywood. So we got a good spice. You know, we keep it fresh, you know. But some people don't know. Like, you single. So you should have what they call Lance Happy Time. A lot of it. The man on some gloves. He can lube and port it from all kind of islands. So we got different perspectives how, you know, you spice up the thing. You seeing somebody?
I see people. I got contacts in. But this is the thing.
Wait, don't mumble that. Be clear. Let people know about your contacts. Don't try to get out of that. Now we talking about we gonna do love for Lance. We gonna have a girl come in every podcast. And we gonna send Lance on a movie and dinner, which I'm gonna pay for, and then they gonna kick it. And then the next
he paying for it, so we going somewhere nice. I'm gonna treat you like royalty, baby. We going to Dairy Queen.
Yeah, that's his idea of whatever. So you get a hot dog and a conversation with this. Anyway, I'm gonna send you somewhere with Lance. And then the guy's a good guy. Get to know Lance. And then the next podcast, you'll come back and tell about the situation and see if you want to go again. If not, Dan's going to go out with somebody else. We're going to see how it goes. Now, he's a good brother, but I don't know how females look at him. Give me your Snapchat again.
Sexual Charcoal. On Snapchat. Follow me. Sexual Charcoal. Sexual Charcoal.
If he was a stripper, he'd be Magic Marker. Sexual Sharpie. Like, yeah, somehow charcoal. Anyway, so we're talking about spicing up your love life. I believe in, I don't like the same thing over and over. I like to go over, I always go out the box. I'm always going out the box. A lot of guys don't think their girl got it no more. You know, it's like you be with your woman so long, and it's the casual thing. It's cool, you know, he ain't going nowhere. He love you, you love him, this and this. But where's the, what? Where's the out the box? That
excitement.
Where's that at?
Unexpected.
Where's that at? Right. A lot of people missing that.
I'll tell you about, because I know you want.
Yeah.
The most.
You say you know my wife like something he about to tell me.
Like I got a secret, like I got a confession.
Don't be sexual coffin fitter. Don't be sexual deceased. I know your wife.
Oh, no, really?
No. Tell me more.
Tell me more. Let me put it on speaker, son of a bitch.
Oh, that if I do first?
All right.
Call Bay.
We have special guests. I can call Bay. Hey, this my little nephew.
Nah, Dad, I'm telling your wife is beautiful, smart, funny. You like, it, I don't know if it's the right, but you got like a trophy wife. But it's like, you won the prize.
You think so?
She got a participation ribbon.
She got a participation ribbon. Then with me, I'm a dime. But I told my daughter I'm a dime. She said, is that because you like everything to be 10 cents? Because she didn't know I'm cheap. My wife, she high end. She go, her manicure is like $120. I go to the meow, meow, meow. I go to them chicks. My shit $12.99.
To the meow, meow, meow.
One time I was getting a manicure, and the lady was just, you know how they massage your hand at the end. You don't get a manicure, they just put the lotion.
I'm a thug.
Or you bite your shit.
Yeah.
You let you hang your hand out the window and let squirrels eat on your fingers. It's good, I'm good. Here's your nuts. Y'all share the nuts. Then you let the squirrels eat on your finger. Get a manicure, piece of shit. So So, you know, so she, anyway, we got a good relationship. So when we're talking about spicing up love life, I don't think you can relate because you don't have a love life long enough.
Why you say that?
This is your love life. Right here. You go, I see you going here. And you want to hit it from the back, you turn this around. But you talk about it. You be talking at the same time. You like that? You do you? Do you?
With a mirror?
In a mirror. In a picture of Beyonce with her mouth cut out. Just staring at it. Thinking that she... So anyway, we got some special guests in the house tonight. We going to talk to... you want to introduce, I guess?
Hell yeah.
Introduce, I guess. What's this? This is how we get down.
This is the lovely Jess.
What?
That's Jess.
Jess?
Jess is short for Jess Amazing.
Jess Amazing?
Yeah. Jessica.
Jessie Lynn.
Jessie Lynn.
Jessie Lynn. Woo! Yeah. Who we got over here?
It's my AKA Finesse.
What?
Finesse.
What? We talking about...
That's the first time I seen him with a shirt off. Oh. I always see him oiled up. He always...
And it's new. You see the packet line. We just got it from Macy's. Because we talking about the life... Okay, we regular guys got regular lives. We got exotic dancers in the house. And they entertain people. And they make a lot of people happy as shit. Because a lot of people... I mean, without them, it... I mean, what... You have a whole lot of fights. This is stress relievers right here. These are stress relievers. And I commend them. I'm like, hey, I compliment them. So we're going to talk to them about a little bit about the other world. Because I'm capable. I was a stripper at the Western Union for about a year. I kept going to jail. I didn't know it was frowned upon.
And that established.
I had a thong on when somebody trying to fill out their paperwork. So I had to leave that career alone. It didn't last too long. You used to strip at the zoo, right? Look at the elephant. Who's that next to him? Who's that with the elephant? The elephant going, yeah! I think he's an elephant teaser. He's the pleaser.
Can't do that when I'm drinking water. I can't have that happen while I'm trying to drink water.
Ladies and gentlemen, get your cameras ready and your dollars. Elephant and the elephant pleaser. You got the little sunshine on there. That's your favorite move. So, we got Mike and what? Tell me something. What's your performance name?
Performance name is Finesse.
Finesse?
Yes.
See, I thought it was. What did I say yesterday? What I said?
Ludacris.
No, I said it was something. I said his name is Sexual Something, or it was something. And I said, what is his stage name? And he said, I don't know. I said, maybe it's like, I said something crazy. It was like, I don't know.
I forgot.
Dragon something? It was something. Finesse?
Yeah.
He almost called you Ludacris.
I know, he did it again.
And what's your?
Jessie Lynn.
When they said, give it up for Jessie Lynn, that's just like that? Mm-hmm. Not cauliflower or like Sexual Sunshine or.
No.
The Lift Notes.
No, give it up for the Lift Notes.
So, there's no way you can argue her and these coming at you like this. Can I? Yeah, whatever. Do what you want. Put the titties up. Do what you want. So.
You're right. I'm wrong.
Let's go left field. What kind of woman are you? Like, it's sort of like, what do you, like, Christmas coming around. What do you want for Christmas? What a woman like you want for Christmas?
I'm actually the giver on Christmas.
You're the giver?
I'm the giver.
Look at God.
What you got on? I got 50. Okay, how much you got? We're going to have a family meeting real quick. They ain't going to get a shit right there. Oh, you got the card. So give. Where do we slide this at? Where do we slide this at? So you more give on Christmas? Like hypothetically, you, Christmas comes, what do you, because usually exotic dancers live a lavish life. They live a life of, people give them stuff.
Who are you asking that I get it from?
Yeah, like
and people that I'm dancing.
Just like
for.
No, like your family.
Family, friends, family. Boyfriend.
I don't boyfriend. I don't typically ask my family for anything.
No, but then they don't get you nothing for Christmas.
They do, but I like to spoil them.
So what do you like? I'm trying to find out. The other side that people don't know about you. What do you, if you
motorcycle
just had a good Christmas gift?
Motorcycle parts.
You like motorcycle
parts? You
got parts?
A motorcycle?
Mm-hmm.
I get on the back.
With a car head again.
I'm turned on like a motherfucker. We a car head. I'm going to have to client. Let me get you.
I got a pre-declined credit card in the mail. Now I got to work on my responses. What? Run it again.
Y'all got to say that shit. You embarrassed a line full of people.
What? I just put money in there. What? You gotta say that.
I just put money in my.
So
credit
you,
card.
You got the motorcycle.
I do.
And so you—that's your passion.
That's my passion.
I would never thought that. That's dope. I like that. If you had to choose, this kind of guy I am. Give me this for Christmas, and I'm happy. What would it be?
Oil.
Skates.
Nah, roller skates. This shit. This shit. We ain't doing this. You on that bitch like? They pushing kids out the way and shit.
I need a ticket to Brazil. I just want to go away.
So you like to travel?
Yeah.
Brazil. I heard about Brazil. Yes. Oh,
you
God.
Going to Jamaica next week?
Jamaica next week? No.
You going to Jamaica? How you don't lie.
Everybody don't know he going. And she, he's like.
Oh, see, then nobody know he going.
Yeah. She said, ain't you going to Jamaica? He said, bitch. I ain't bringing you here to talk about that.
They asked him to spell Jamaica. No, I'm like, yeah. He's like, yeah, Court, did you see him kill him? Yeah. I ain't never seen nobody with the peanut butter in their mouth. Nah.
Oh, man.
So you're a trap. You like to.
Yeah.
That's where you. You happy at? Yeah. And you happy stacking your motorcycle up, getting fast?
Going fast.
What kind of motorcycle do you have?
I have a Road Glide, a Harley Road Glide, and a Rocky.
You know
big
I'm getting...
one.
Yeah, so I'm about to...
Maybe a bet.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Get out of here. Damn. And I'm about to go... I just priced a scooter.
One of these? Don't do that.
I'm getting a scooter. Not that. I'm talking about this. The scooter, I'm gonna wear all leather though. I'm going
think
dope.
It goes 35 miles an hour.
I'm gonna need to go 40.
It's not gonna
I just leave earlier.
Turbo
I just leave earlier. I'm gonna get the same one you see the Chinese do delivering Chinese food. But I'm gonna get all leather. I'm gonna have badass on the back.
You can't have badass.
I'm gonna have a helmet with the, you can't even see, you go tinted mask. I'm gonna be looking at it. What? I'm not getting I can't do a motorcycle. I just can't.
I burn rubber.
I ride with you. No, you look dangerous. It. You'll go on the grass on the highway. You just like, forget the highway. Just get on the grass. Forget this exit. We're going up the grass. Hell no, you'll kill us. So, relationship wise.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh.
How's that going? Do you even look for that?
It don't go that very well.
It don't. Is it like a trust?
I think it's an insecurity on their
part. It's got to be. It's
on their part, you said.
On their part.
You're comfortable and you.
Absolutely.
So you would want to be in a relationship.
I don't care who you are. You want to be loved.
I do.
I don't care who you are.
But first, I think I'll like them, and then I don't like them, and then I just get rid of them.
But you don't like them because they start getting uncomfortable. And it's bothering you, or
it's the insecurity.
Yeah, it's got to be.
It's an insecurity.
What kind of questions? So when you say insecurity, what kind of things does a man say that let you know, okay, this ain't gonna work?
I heard this. I heard that. But
see,
I don't like that. He said. She said. Like, what have you seen?
Mm-hmm.
And that's.
Well, that's apparently somebody they're jealous of you and they want to go and crash what you got. Cause, you know, and then it's gonna be hard for him not to believe it because. You're sexy, you know, you're a dancer, and then you got these guys, they dream about you, they salivate and everything, but that don't mean that you're doing anything besides dancing.
Right.
So if he don't understand that.
That's the wildest part of my life, besides the motorcycle.
Mm. It's the dancing?
Yeah, I'm a homebody, really.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
On a motorcycle, though?
I don't even dream about
smoke. If you're not Yvonne Knievel, Knievel's
badass
sister.
Jesse Lynn.
God, Jesse Lynn.
Badass Jesse Lynn.
Badass Jesse.
Like Jesse James.
Vroom, vroom.
Jesse James with titties.
I can see badass myself put Jesse next to you in my badass Tony Roberts.
Maybe we should bring it up for you. So you
can see. Yeah, I'm going to see that. I'm going to see that. You should see.
What, as far as dating scene?
What? You're in a steady relationship?
Is that hard? You know what? My relationships last about 3 months.
Really?
I'm going to be honest.
90 days.
It's 90 days, and I already see it coming.
Is it you, or is it your profession?
It's the profession.
Yeah.
You know, they act like they cool with it the first two months.
Yeah.
Then that third month, they'd be like, so when you plan on retiring?
Do you ever date somebody from the job? Like a customer or something?
I tried it. One.
He don't want to talk about this.
Is it her?
he want to talk about Trump some more. He's,
that's going to mess up the fun.
Nah, you know, I tried it once.
Oh, shit.
That's.
Watch this. Oh, my God. Stars and Stripes. Girl, you handling that mother. Damn, that's a big-ass bike. So, she like it big.
Yeah. I did 19 push-ups this morning.
You and that guy to move out the room.
Turn these cameras off.
these lights. What pleases you? You've been and seen everything. It's like you've been in a lot of situations that men dream about and women, you know, scared of or something. I don't know. What pleases you sexually? I got a question.
That was a question.
No. What pleases you? What do you find you get the... And then we're going right to the throat with this one.
Literally.
What do you find you get your greatest orgasm from? Four things. Either intercourse, oral sex, masturbation, or somebody else touching you. As a dog dancer, and you know tease enough people. But what pleases you? What do you get your greatest orgasm from, you think? And of course, oral sex, masturbation, or somebody touching you. This guy, look at you, stand in your face.
That was one for you.
Mike, you first, man. You first.
I don't care.
I'm gonna go with intercourse, but you gotta be skilled at what you're doing, and that's the problem. Like I'll be honest, I've been dancing for a while, so
right.
You know, I've had a few partners, and I've come across some people that's real, real good. So if I come across somebody that's just basic, it don't really do nothing for me. So I like a woman that's a little bit experienced.
Really?
Yeah.
So you don't like, I mean, if she's not that experienced, what about you, you know, blowing her mind, showing her, flipping everywhere, she go, oh my God, you got on the ceiling fan and shit. You know, you got all these tricks for her.
Yeah,
but don't they get you up blowing somebody's mind instead of hanging in with the best?
Now I feel like I'm working. Yeah. I want somebody to blow my mind. Right. I want to sit back and she do something where I'm just like,
you want to be on the ceiling fan.
No, I don't want to be on the ceiling fan.
Because as an entertainer, it does not turn you on at the job, for me at least.
Really?
Yeah, it's mental block.
So which one of those four simulates you the biggest orgasm, or the, you know, the satisfaction? And of course,
I don't think I could just choose one.
But you got to choose one. That's just the topic of the. If you had to choose one, which one would it be? Intercourse, oral sex, masturbation, or someone touching you.
It was intercourse, masturbation, oral, or Lance.
She said masturbation. I agree with that.
I plug it in the wall.
Because my imagination, when I'm masturbating, I got a chick with 5 mouths and 6 pussies. She's an alien, and she's the bitch. She's the shit. And then she got her tail is licking the back of my neck and back of my ass, and I'm doing this, and everything is going on. She is the shit. And she got me in midair. And she hold me up, and the mouths and the pussies everywhere. So I like that. Masturbation, I go where I want to go. And I get the greatest, and I hold firecrackers and shit. A dragon come out. I'm like, fuck you! Take this! So I go there. So I like, yeah. I got hot.
Yeah.
It's hot in here.
Anybody else uncomfortable? Just me? You want to change seats?
So his greatest thing is looking at people's windows. He'd you're on the fifth floor with no ladder. I'm going to sail like this. That's so good. I don't know how I'm going to get down. I don't know how the fuck I got up here. This is great. All right, so we was talking about spicing up a love life. We got a lot of women don't know how to, you know, they either the man is not into it or she's too shy to get into it. She'll try to do something and can't do it right. You know what I'm saying? I had my woman, you know, you don't know what you're doing, and it'd be like, okay, this is a bad idea. Some people go take, some women go take pole dancing classes, right? I sat through one of those classes. They don't work. You know, you don't know how to come down that pole.
She said, you don't really.
So, far as, and then men can just sit their woman down and do, you know, spice her up and everything, but people don't know how to properly do it. I'd like for y'all to properly show our viewers who's looking, because some of y'all are going to need this class. Just a quick sample of what do you do? Like, how do you gradually get somebody ready for a lap dance? Or like a exotic, you know. You want to see my nipple? That was just a random question. Is that on camera? Yeah. I'm just making sure y'all paying attention.
He asked him. I don't know why.
This the other truth. This the truth. This the real deal right here. Okay, before we go into the lap dance, give me some of the cons of being an exotic dancer. What's the bad that can happen?
Bad hygiene. I think
by. Are you serious?
Oh yeah, yeah.
While you approach somebody?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You come up, it's just like, woo.
Are you serious?
But they got like $100 on them.
But you, so you gotta take the skunk.
Yeah.
Then you gotta get that dirty money.
You got. You gotta
hold your breath.
You know what? You should take some. With the stuff, the hand sanitizer, rub your hand and rub them down like sexually, and get the film off of them.
The film off of them.
They smell like a hostage. They've been in there for a week in that basement, and they come like me, and all the flies on their shoulder. Us. You see the flies, but you see the $100 bill. But it's that bad?
Not everything is like what you see on the Magic Mike and all the movies. Like, you're going to get some great shows, but right. You're going to always have that one. And typically, you know by the neighborhood. You know, if you got MapQuest or something, when they can tell you that address.
Right.
So what?
Old Park, G Parkway, better be.
So the address, so this is just like somebody call you to do
party. You have club events and you have house parties. And not every club event is good. I'm sure when y'all travel, you hit some cities where you just like, what is this?
Yeah.
So it's the same thing with us. We might hit a city where it'd be like, wow.
I'm talking about you dancing, you got your thing, and the girls, do they like rough each other up trying to get at you or something? Or have you ever seen a fight?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's normally the shows where there ain't no chairs. When everybody just got to stand around the stage.
Right.
Because everybody want to get up there. And normally, it's that.
What's against?
The women are more aggressive than the men for us. They have to sit there and just.
You do private events? Mm-hmm. So when you at a private event or you at a club and you doing your thing, what's the bag that can happen right there?
If they try to grab you or something like that, and that's when I just stop the show. I take all my money and I go.
Oh, really?
It's been 10 minutes.
If a chick up is just like, fuck it, and just rip your dick out.
Oh, you know, I give her that gentle, hard push.
That boom.
Yeah, because it's
a thin line between exotic dancing and porn. It's a thin line. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It is, and that's, she trying to really get it, and that's, you go to jail for that. If somebody ever try to just pull your thing over and try to.
One tried to grab, I actually hit him with a heel.
Really?
Yeah, because he was very aggressive and he acted like he could not speak English.
Do you think he was going to try to go and just do you?
Well, I don't know.
No, but he's going to get...
He's going to get you and smell his fingers.
Yeah, it was just too much.
The whole room would have smelled that finger. you're too young for that. This is a young man back there. You don't remember this. Look at that.
Wow!
So one guy, you smell like shit. So what the fuck you been doing? Oh, that's me. This the hand with the... I gave you the wrong hand. This the hand with the vagina. This is my ass. It's on the way here. So, So I like to see, like, okay, first I would like, we're going to put the chairs like right here. Can we put the chair right here?
Yeah.
Sorry. And I'm going to see, what do I do? Like, I'm gonna do this on my wife. We leaving tonight. I leave on a 9-day road trip. We'll be in a hotel. So I'm going to put her in a chair and try to do the, but I'm corny. Yeah. I'm going to start pop locking.
I hope you ain't got one of these chairs. These are not for lap dance.
They're not? Yeah. Do we have one for lap? What about the stool? You got to have something with the back, right?
You got a
more upright, right?
Like, yeah.
Computer chair?
More upright?
Computer chair?
What about this chair here?
The computer chair.
Yeah, without the armrest?
Yeah, your armrest is what kill you.
Oh, because
the person has to get
so on you. So you're talking about being without any armrest? Yeah. Yeah,
no armrest.
See, I see it.
If I...
That's
yeah. Too low, huh?
I sit on this table if the cause is right.
Are you serious? All right, so we're going to pretend that...
Takes no armrest.
Well, do what you do with the improvise. With this, if a girl that you really want to say, hey, I want you to have sex with me, but in this chair, would you make it happen?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, we'll make this dance happen. So can we get a like a sample or just a?
So we got to take Jesse Lynn from your chair. We're gonna move it.
Yeah, let's set the room.
Yeah.
Cause I wanna see.
We'll slide her chair over to the corner.
Cause we don't know. I don't know. I never gave my woman a little.
No, underneath one. Huh?
You gotta on your mind. You can keep your chair right there. Finesse, and we gonna
Yeah, they're
all.
You're better off in this computer.
Really?
Yeah.
I'll bring it over right now.
Yeah,
my computer is a little more
upright.
Is your manager?
Yeah. She had all the talking. I know. So, can you lap dance her?
No.
Wait, this ain't. You ain't got to say so here.
No.
Man, you did that pretty good. You like a stripper. Can you move that back like that?
Is that better?
Oh, sorry.
This might work.
Sorry.
This might work.
So no, can you give her a leg dance?
Can I see how that look on camera? Move is the camera over there?
Oh, yeah.
Let me move this over a little bit.
Come on.
Okay, so what I want to know is, do you, okay, so you the girlfriend, you the wife.
Okay.
You, this my wife, you me, but... With a little, you know, better little finesse on it. You, I'm the before, you the after.
Music?
Yeah, put a picture of him on my window. I'm going to be like that.
Yeah, I guess so. What's the song? We'll throw it on right now.
Yeah. So, what is the main thing?
It might
thing?
Be better on your phone just to play it over there. I don't
what
know.
Is the main thing I'm looking for? I don't want to just, you know, just me. Hey, baby, sit there. Okay, that ain't no sexy. That ain't sexy. That's all I know.
All right, so
I don't want to do that.
That's a felony.
Yeah. If it's your woman, I mean, you got to tease her anyway. That's half of the whole exotic thing.
Okay.
So it's pretty much just eye contact and teasing her.
Okay.
So what you gonna do? Whether you.
But I want to treat her. I want to treat her like she's a I'm a exotic dancer and she's just a stranger.
Right.
We want to go out the box. Okay. So I'm gonna treat her special.
Yeah.
So I start from back there with the shoulders and stuff.
Yeah. So I mean, pretty much.
Man, we need some music.
All right.
Okay. Sorry about that. She's like a police officer. I don't want to yell at her. Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute.
Make sure my car.
With the motorcycle?
No. I'm riding.
It's gorgeous.
Mm-hmm.
It's
okay. Yeah, sorry.
You stand up. What you doing? Can you focus on the whole picture?
No.
Get off these. Show to your eyes.
They was looking at me first.
Look, he an eye rapier. He done had sex with you twice, broke up, went to your job, stalked you. Y'all got back together. He had sex again. Then he back in this room.
They typically do that to me.
What? They break up with you and come back?
All of that.
That's what they... I was about to agree with you until... You wiggle. Once you wiggle.
Do me all up.
I
Okay. Can you hear him if you talk?
Yeah. All right. Barely, barely.
Okay.
All right, so basically, you want a teaser.
I want a teaser.
Yeah, so you just coming back.
Okay.
You might start touching on her.
All right.
Now, you ain't getting crazy with it.
No, because it wouldn't be a tease if I just grabbed it.
Then you might want to mess with her ears that she like.
All right.
Might be her ear. Then, as you come around, you're going to want her to touch you as well.
Okay.
So you might go with something with a hip roll. And you're going to let her touch. You're going to let her touch.
What'd you do with your knee?
The knee go out forward. That's a hip roll. So hip roll with it. No, you got to go. This way. And you're going to work her hand down.
I got to work on that.
Down.
Okay.
Now, if it's your wife.
Okay.
Then you're going to come back up.
Okay.
Then you're going to come in front of her.
All
right. Hopefully your chair ain't got no arm. There we go. Then you just break it down. And it's all on your hip. It's all on your stroke.
You see that?
Stroke.
Pay attention.
Hip.
Okay.
Stroke.
All right, turn it sideways. Turn it sideways so we can see the camera. Now show the followers, show our listeners. Our viewers, the hip thing again on her lap.
Yeah, the stroke. Yep.
The stroke. Because we ain't, pay attention. You're going to need this in your love life.
It's all in the stroke.
See?
So you got to come with the stroke.
Okay.
Don't be stiff with it.
Okay.
You know.
Stiff like what?
You know, some people need this. It's just real stiff. That's not the stroke.
Pay attention.
You got to put your hip on it.
Okay.
That chair pregnant.
Yeah. Okay, so now, when you get in front of her, do you get on your knees? Do you act like you do something or?
You can do a whole lot of things.
So you mix it up?
Yeah.
When will I take my shirt off?
Never. You don't take your shirt off.
What the fuck do you mean by that?
I mean, you shake like a punter. Keep your goddamn shirt off. That's what I mean.
This is the last show. Alright, so.
Oh, undo it. Once you're ready to lay her down,
lay her down?
Well, yeah. You know, so you just not in a chair. You lay her down.
Lift them upside down, lay them down.
You get a little more extensive. You start touching.
Snake them. What? Give poison? What you mean, snake them?
Also, I was just thinking about
it. Because I need this to show my wife, show the women out here how to seduce a man.
You can show me because.
I forgot. We got plans.
I don't like this part of the job, but I gotta do it.
You didn't go to sleep last night thinking about this.
But
shit.
I need this.
What? You never judge you walk.
You using an electric chair. Look at them with an electric chair. You can pull the switch. Why he on this chair? That's the only way he gonna get up.
Jesus, curse you.
Plug the chair in. Let me pull the switch on this bastard.
Yeah.
This is Life of an Exotic Dancer, and we trying to show you how to spice your love life up. Now, Mike just showed us how to get down. Men, get in there. Take it easy. Don't go straight for the ass. The ears, the wave, get the stroke down. Got to do that thing. Now, we got Lance is going to...
I'm doing this for y'all, people. I don't even want to be here.
She's going to show the females.
But you should go all the way.
Men might like it a little different.
Where should I go? All the way. Come on. Back here? Like that?
Okay. Men might like it a little different. So yeah.
What you need me to do?
Because men like it a little more aggressive.
Okay.
Women.
Okay. Okay. All right.
So this is. Now this is.
Just put them on the side.
All right, hold on. Turn the sideways. Turn the chair sideways. Because we can't see you.
Then we don't need to see anybody sure. Right now.
I know, but I want to make sure. Okay, there you go. There you go.
Just keep my hands
go for it. See, there you go.
Okay. And you know.
Now, Lance, ladies, that's what you gotta do. You just gotta.
Oh, I don't know if this is gonna work.
I don't know. What's under there? Nothing?
Nothing.
No, it's fine.
You know, we just go for it. Shit. No, we just edit it.
I don't mind. Yeah.
I'm thanking the Lord for this job. Oh my God, are you serious? Oh my God, are you serious? Now, I don't know. I'm trying to see where my wife at. Pay attention, honey. I want you to... All it is some arm strength and some will. Some willpower.
You gotta have the will to win.
All right, do you? Now, do you put the breast in his mouth or are you just teasing him?
Just tease him.
Just tease him? Because that was a tease. That last move was a tease. Oh my God. Don't get no black. Don't get no smudge on your dress. That's like lap dancing a tire. Oh my God. She took the knee and rubbed it on his crotch. It's her shin. That's art. I would never thought of that.
I wouldn't have thought of it either, but I like it.
See, this is, oh, Jesus. And
you don't want to put too much pressure on him.
Why not? What you mean?
Because then it hurts. You have to, it just has to be gentle.
So you grazing him? He's getting grazed. She's not slamming it on his,
right.
Yeah. See, on his Vienna and two M&M's. You don't want to snap the Vienna sausage and two M&M's.
Right.
You want to.
You know, when I worked at Carl's Jr., I never had these problems.
See, that kind of. What the fuck? That kind of shit I'm talking about. This is some people, pay attention. This is what you're going to need to know when you're.
So when you're doing this, do people keep like a straight face?
Yeah, what do people mostly look at? You, your eyes, and you. You like the snake and the bird hypnotism?
Yeah, I stare them in their eyes most of the time.
Do they ever whisper like, can you do this? And you go, no, that's against the rules.
I'm going to whisper something to you. You do it. I'm going to whisper something back. You're going to whisper. Okay. Who's going to whisper first?
Well, we need some ear. I need to hear this. Okay, but you got to tell me what you whispered.
Okay.
You're not going to get the pleasure. I don't want to know what you whispered.
I got to whisper something first.
Why don't you give him this PIN number and shit?
He ain't got no money.
Good thing he ain't got my PIN number.
That's what I whispered, right?
That's what he whispered. I got no special money. Dance, but the dance you just got, you couldn't either go to the ATM or let the bouncers do it.
Go to the ATM.
Oh, that's not
she
a whisper.
Said.
Okay, wait a minute. I
that lap dance, you can go to the ATM. Okay, so when a guy, you lap dancing a guy, and you got him, how do you know he's really loving it? I mean, besides, you feel him, he's a wreck. When you feel that, do you really, did it makes you feel better? Like you're not, you doing your job?
Most of them are going to enjoy it. Some of them just don't want to spend the money.
What do you mean?
Some of them just really don't have the money.
So
they want it, but they just don't got it.
So when somebody go for one dance, one song, is that because do women pay for lap dance per song like men?
Well, women is different.
Right.
They just keep paying.
They'll have like a stack.
They'll keep paying.
And men, we normally just take it. We're a little bit more aggressive.
So men try to get more for little.
You can keep dancing while he answering questions.
But you don't have the money.
No, that was
wrong. That's how it works.
That's fact.
That's the fact. That's the fact.
I meant I'm a billionaire.
We got. All right, come on, man. Get back over here.
Why? Wait a minute.
Because we gotta go on with the show.
The show.
I want them to see. Because I'm gonna try this. I think I'm gonna work on that
move. There was some moves you didn't teach him.
I'm gonna work on that.
And get the chair. That's the first part.
Yeah. I'm gonna have a regular chair in the hotel.
Yeah, get you a good chair. That's where.
I didn't know the chair was
there. Yeah, get you a good chair.
I had no idea. Move this back up so they can hear him talk right here. Yeah. You come back over here. Yeah. Cut the music. Have a real party going on in here. We don't want to go where we ain't supposed to go. We still doing the show. We don't want to.
I need a cigarette.
So. I need a cigarette. You better go to sleep. You ain't did nothing. So. Are you just.
What's up,
lap dance.
Yeah,
mouse.
It's over.
A mouse.
Yep, I'm never coming home. Yep. We'll leave with a minute.
It was up to the kids, homie.
Tell the kids I still love them, but not like I love her. I like them. I miss that shot. All right, bitch.
Hey, babe. Somebody going to be staying with us for about a month. Why you got an attitude? She ain't did none of you. You talk to her there. We going there. So, Just talking about what were you doing before you were an exotic dancer? What were you doing?
Oh, I was at the gym, personal training.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You still do that?
Yeah. I do it independent now.
So I need to, I'm going to, well, I got a trainer. He cool. I mean, that's my boy Ryan. He competes and everything, but I'm going to maybe get different perspective on stuff. Okay, well, I'm talking to you about that too. So you went from there, and how you, somebody, you just went and just.
Somebody, I'll be honest, somebody approached me.
No, hold on. When somebody say, I'm be honest, that means they about to lie. Because if you got to say that, then why would you try to convince us that you're going to be honest? You're supposed to be honest from the get-go. People say, I'm going to be honest with you. No, you're not.
What's your real name?
You're trying to disguise this. What's your real name, Demi? His name is Arnold. And you were a plumber.
Oh. He just do sit-up.
Man, into somebody's sink. So you okay? I'll be all right. You got a leak. So you're a personal trainer, and then how did this happen?
Somebody came up to me in a gym and told me, hey, you should start stripping.
And somebody just said that?
Yeah, yeah.
Like that man stripping in the gym?
No.
You were in the middle of your set. You took your shorts off.
It was like, you in shape. You should come dance. And then I was just like, nah, I ain't into that.
So what pushed you over there? Like, you went to one of their events?
Bills?
No, the third time, he was like, I know you ain't into it, but 100 women, 4 dudes. I was like, 100 women? I go, all right. So I went and checked it out. And then the first time I checked it out, women was just throwing money. I think I was like 19.
And well, I didn't think they was like hiring like that. They just.
Well, I come from an underground circuit. Like, there's mainstream, and then there's underground.
So there's a Thunder Down Under, Chippendale.
Yeah. You and got then, them. That's mainstream.
Yeah, that's the real mainstream.
Yeah.
He underground like
then
a,
you got
he like a street ball. He like an N1 basketball player.
So you underground. You like
he hot sauce.
Yeah. You, man, you in the back of Carl Jr.
No, we ain't in the back.
Private
Carl.
Dance.
Hey, we's at your spot. We's at Tommy T.
Yeah.
Talking about
once a month, right? Something like that.
Yeah.
Another guy goes to the gym on Sunrise. Slim guy, more slim than you, dark skin.
I don't know.
Forgot his damn name. It's in my phone. Anyway, yeah. What about you?
Well, I was young.
Mm-hmm.
I was working actually at a porn theater.
How young? Like you needed a permission slip?
I turned 18 and started working at this porn theater. You mm-hmm. remember on Watt Avenue?
No, I'm not from here. I'm from Detroit.
Okay. Well, they've burnt it down since.
That's so, like Detroit. They burnt it down.
How long did you work there?
A few months, mm-hmm. and people kept coming in telling me I should be a dancer.
I'm sorry. What is a porn theater?
Yeah, right. That part. They come in. It's just like a movie theater, but instead of...
He's young. He don't know... Don't worry about that.
Instead of regular movies...
You watch porn.
You watch porn.
Okay.
That stuff is planted to porn theater. Puppy Palace. You go in there and buy a puppy. What the fuck? Plant World. You think I'm fine? Roller coasters in that bitch? Listen to it. Porn theater.
You go to Six Flags, it's not one flag.
In the door, it's 6 of them bitches. at the front, it's 6 flags.
I never been.
So, I started.
They go to the dentist and drop his drawers. You think he getting a rectal exam? It's a this. If you go to the dentist and they say, let me see your ball so you can cough. You're in the wrong goddamn. He's abusing you. He's molesting you. So, you did that. And somebody said, both of y'all, you should be a dancer?
Well, yeah. Well, I put a tip jar at my job. Uh-huh. They didn't have that before me.
Right.
But if you're going to stare and you want to talk to me.
You like the Jackie Robinson of porn theaters.
I'm pretty good at getting money.
Okay.
Mm.
Hey, I'm pretty good at it.
I like that. Yeah. Yep. Feeling that. Go ahead.
And so, I started doing amateur nights. So
like open mic.
So, basically. So, like Tuesdays, Wednesdays, open and pole. Thursday, I would go do amateur contests to the point that, and I would make $500 in like a minute and a half.
As an amateur?
Just to do the contest. $500 for a minute and a half? I was okay with that, right? Until they told me I couldn't do amateur night anymore. I either take the job or I can't do amateur night. So then I took the job.
Hmm. Where were you, your first job? What club?
Pure Gold.
Oh, Sunrise. Yeah. I live down the street from there.
That was my
first. You underground. You underground. So you still you do venues.
Yeah, we go to every venue that's out here. That's how we got into Tommy T's. Mm.
Every venue, they go to Tommy
Club. Where you at now?
Churches.
Where can they find you now? If somebody's in Sacramento.
On the cross.
If you're in Sacramento, where can they find you?
You
go to different places?
Yeah.
You like freelance?
Basically.
Can they do that?
Yeah, basically.
Oh, I thought you had to be like...
Exclusive to one
club. Yeah.
Well, the thing is, when you're exclusive, you can't make money elsewhere. Like,
the
mainstream
right.
people, they can only dance through their company.
Right.
When you're independent, you can travel, go wherever you want.
So, see, I didn't know that you can walk in the club, and as long as you give them their percentage, they don't care.
They don't care.
So what about the other girls?
To work there.
What about the other girls?
Oh, they're typically a problem. Actually, Pure Gold, I went from like $10 a night to $160 a night to work there.
Really?
So you were making $10 a night?
No. It was costing me $10 to work there. So now if I walk in, it's $160.
Well, I've been in there a couple of times. I've seen some National Geographic titties there. I mean, you had to tip a girl and just look at the titties like this and go back up. Yeah, those nipples are hard.
She stepped, one girl stepped on a titty.
So rolled the bitch back up, put it back in the bra, had to pin them up, put the thing to put on the bread so it won't get on the potato chips so it won't get stale.
A bad clip.
But you don't have that. You don't have that situation there.
It's pretty rough out there now.
Yeah, I believe it. I mean, competition.
Right. So this is the thing: it was a rougher club, but when you're making $1,200 to $2,800 a night.
Who the fuck does that?
You don't care what is going on.
She ain't answer the question.
$1,200 to $2,800.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly.
American money.
American dollars.
Sound like pesos.
Shit. American life.
We in the wrong profession.
Hell yeah. It's just taking too long. Yeah.
So they talk about us, but most women that could do it would do it.
If they had
the confidence
and
the body and the face, they would do it.
But these bitches shaped like IKEA. They can't strip.
And they're so mad at me.
Yes.
Zero IKEA.
Them ones you be dating.
They got two stories.
Right.
Ice cream.
He did that when he hit on him and they about to come and flip him off. He go, oh, wait a minute. They ain't got a party.
It's hard to leave this profession.
How long you been dancing?
14 years.
14?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
You can go that long?
I'm about to retire. I got two more years.
You got like a retirement party?
Yeah, I'm going to line dance. I'm going to some grown stuff. I got two more years.
Take a two-step.
I'm doing some steps after that.
I had planned on
retiring. I want to roar. I don't know that voice. You know what I'm doing with this show?
Cut. Mike, whoa. Finesse.
So how long you been dancing?
Since 2002.
That's 14 years.
Wow, damn. It was about the same.
Yeah.
You ever dance together? You ever run into each other?
I met
at a party?
I met her 13 years ago. I went and danced for some of her friends.
Oh, really?
Just before I even knew who she was.
Oh, really?
And then, yeah. And I had the same look y'all had. I was like, damn, you know.
What look do we got?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah.
That's 14 years and it's still like this?
Yeah.
So, do you think about, like, do we have potential? You think we got potential to make a couple of dollars?
Oh, yeah.
Underground, like under a porch?
In the attic?
In the attic?
Attic shows is
I mean, a little extra
back.
Money wouldn't hurt.
I'm an international sex symbol. Everybody knows that. Follow me on Snapchat, Sexual Charcoal.
Sexual Firewood. This is 9/11 rubble. And I'm sexy about this goddamn. You can be a stripper though. You could. You can do it, man. You young. Go out there. Go out there and do something. You ain't doing shit else.
So I don't dance as much as I used to though. I actually started my own company with dancers. But I just get a lot of requests when I try to.
So you do special events now. They want you to come out.
Oh, so you're like a madam.
No. I'm not saying, woman.
Well, I'm not saying you get them selling ass. I'm just saying you got your own company
to
and you.
Get me in jail on here.
No, she's not a madam.
She's a male.
So you just
moved
you manage them.
You just, moved into a mogul spot.
I help them get their clients.
That's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Exactly. You like a manager. You're just like an agent. You got an agency now. That's the best way to go. Mm-hmm. That's the best way to go. Do you know the term hooker, where that come from?
No, I don't.
The lady, they had girls on the streets. This lady, her last name was Hooker. Okay. And she was the first madam to have women on the street. And so they said, those are the hooker girls. They belong to Miss Hooker. And that's where the term come from.
You know where I thought it came from?
I never knew. Yeah.
I thought when a pimp say, that bitch don't listen, so I had to hook her. And I thought that's where it came from.
Take your head off in the house.
That's what I thought it came from.
That's my grandmama's.
That's what I thought
you
it came
managed.
From.
You managed. You gonna mind somebody.
You gonna mind somebody?
My uncle used to say that. What if I listen to him? Oh, you ain't gonna be me, but you gonna mind somebody.
Because as women, it gets hard for us to continue to go out there and work like that as we get older.
I know it.
So when I turned
man too.
30, so you going, yeah, I know.
When I turned 30, I was like, okay.
So you're not going to do it like an agency type thing or just no, take young dancers and show them?
No, I got my own company. This is finesse.com. And I normally promote dancers from out of town.
Oh,
so
really?
I'll fly New York, Texas, and them dancers in.
Right.
And give the people of Sacramento something different to look at because there's so many different styles.
Well, my wife's mom... birthday's coming up. I'm sure she's Filipino. She's like, she's going to be 60 something. And I want you to come in there and hook her up. She'll never speak to me again if you walk in that bitch with your shirt off.
Ain't that what you want?
With a lizard on your dick. Let me tell you something. So I used to tour around with Cheryl Underwood.
Okay.
And she used to travel with like four strippers, right? And so the deal was, we get up, the show starts, she hosts, two other comics go up, I go last in the show, boom! Everybody know the strippers coming up, so it'd be full of women come in, come on ladies, so she go out there and on the mic and then one at a time. So one day she had to go do another gig, and we had to do the gig without her. So she told them, Tony's going to host the stripper part, she's going to host the dancing part. I'm like, what the fuck, why not? I'm the more experienced comic, so I'm more experienced on the mic. So this is the most uncomfortable shit in the world. So now I got to go get their names right and go get the order. So I go in the room. These niggas all masturbating.
Down south. Yeah.
Some got video. Some got the sex book. They all doing this. I said, hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Come out one at a time and give me your order. Hey, how you want me to bring you up? This is bullshit. So I go out there. This is the second craziest part. While they on the stage, on the floor, they doing their thing, I got to amp them up, amp the ladies up. Ladies, look at them. Ain't he sexy? Wow. Look at him go.
Look at him
what
go.
What the fuck? Then he just started giving some girl in her face and sticking her face like the thing they have over the thing. I said, can you swallow that? I gotta get another job. I was so embarrassed. It's just so uncomfortable. I'm like, yeah, whatever. So, that was my experience.
So, you're saying I got potential?
Yeah.
I can do it.
Yeah, I think anybody.
No, don't say anybody. No, I'm saying me
you
particularly.
Mean anybody. That's depends on your crowd. I can see you in a hospital in Haiti. And they on dialysis. Well, we're in the third world country. They got three diseases. And here you come.
You do not need a degree for this.
No, look, I need some specific. No, you got it.
I just can't tell you
CBC Majid
what kind of money you'll make.
You said I can't do what?
Right in front of the coffee door.
We just can't tell you how much money you're going to make.
Across there?
I'm an international sex. Listen, check this out.
International sex? You ain't got a passport.
I don't need that.
Jesus.
I was in Yuba City the other day. They love me.
Yuba City makes sense.
Population 12.
And out of
he brought six of them people with him.
Look, out of 12, 11 of them was feeling me. So
because you're chocolate.
Sexual charcoal.
On Halloween, he just take off all his clothes and he's an alley. Trick or treat, they go right to the door like somebody just ran the door. I don't see nothing.
Well, they're not used to seeing sexual charcoal there.
Such sexual choices.
Why don't you give it a shot? Go to work with him and see. Just give it like Magic Mike. That's the first time and see what it do. Just see if you get any money at all. I mean, you might get a few dollars, but it might your comp. You never know where you at in this game.
I think
go with him.
I'm gonna go with you.
Go with him. No, really. Go with him.
We'll put it together.
Okay.
And just your next performance, go ahead and say y'all like introduce a newcomer to the house, blah, blah, blah. Y'all give him a warm welcome. Blade. The Daywalker. You come out there with a cape and shit. And the sword in your back. Shing, shing. And then chop your clothes off. Chop your clothes off. And then you just go in there and start doing, do the Running Man. They love the Running Man.
They love the Running Man.
It makes your dick look bigger. It start juggling around. So, like you got a package. Always do the Running Man first. And then do the hammer. Uh-oh.
Kill him.
Yeah. Okay. And don't get too close. Don't let them touch you. They're going to know. They're going to know it's a remote control in there. You don't stuff the shit with a remote control.
A universal
remote. They're going to say, whoa, it's hard. Is that hard? And then soon you do it, the TV going to go on. You're going to go, what the fuck? This is not a dick. This is a remote control. Two garage doors open. Because he stuffed this shit with a remote control. Garage door open. So, I say go give it a shot.
I'm there.
You hear the other two. Tony Roberts.
Sexual charcoal.
Lance Wood's going to do his debut. He's going to do his debut as a dancer. Just to see what he do. Because he say the sexual sex symbol. Which
international sex
international symbol. Sex symbol. Which... I believe only together. Stevie Wonder can see that in Helen Keller. So, you and all your audience members got canes and dogs. And he go, he smells good. Give him a 20. But they can see you in Braille. And they see that and go, oh my God, it's Danny Glover. Got a purple Danny Glover? Yeah, bitch. I see this. I'm shoving his face.
He smell good, and the dog keep barking. No, 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 no.
So I think you should go there, man.
I'm going. I'm gonna bring my auntie to dance.
You should blog that and say I'm going to do my. But you gotta get naked. Just wear your boxer trunks. Wear your shit. Wear some briefs, and just go out there and just
some tidy whities.
You gonna wear a thong?
Nah, you ever wearing thongs?
He's a goddamn dancer.
So you have to?
Yeah. You think he wear pajama pants? What do you think he got? What you think he got on?
I don't know. I ain't never seen no
man. Man got a scuba dive. He's not the goddamn. He's not skiing, goddamn. The women won't pay for clothes.
I ain't never been. So I need a thong.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Don't go get the one. Well, I mean, I don't know. We get ours custom made, but
you might have to wear yours backwards.
Okay.
You want to even impress somebody?
All right.
Oh, but how you go with a string and just pull the string?
Don't go get the one size fit all. I'm just saying. Like,
so, hey, you did good today. What's your name? My name is Lance Woods.
It's like a wrestler. It's gonna be the one.
What the thing with the round here, like a lid, like a.
You got to leave that.
No, you gotta go. You gotta go because you ain't gonna have the package. You ain't gonna have the shoulders, the rolls. So you gotta go that Nacho Libre thing. You gotta go with the one piece, and just and let them know. They're gonna be like, oh my God, he's so different. You gonna be like the different one.
Okay.
And let it be white, and you like some piano keys. You like one, two, three piano keys. You like black. You like a nun falling down the stairs. Black. A nun falling down the stairs. This is like black. So, do that shit.
I'm doing it.
Y'all hear me?
I'm doing
the
it.
The truth, and we don't lie.
I'm gonna
Lance Woods
talk
going
about
out
it.
With Finesse, Mike, aka Finesse.
It's gonna be a movie.
Witness. You gotta witness this. She's going with him to witness this thing.
Yeah, I'm gonna put it. I'm gonna put
coaching, help him out.
I'm gonna put it on Snapchat. Which you should follow me at.
And that's how long it's gonna last. 10 seconds. That's how long it's gonna last. He ain't gonna get to the first chorus of the song.
What?
His ass gonna fall. He gonna fall and hurt his wrist. Show them what they're looking forward to.
They ain't pay for that.
What you mean?
You didn't pay for it either.
They got two exotic dancers here.
Didn't even get paid to be here.
Ladies, this is the international sex symbol right here.
I think it's a game.
I think it's a game.
I'll just let you know.
You got a tank top on? Take the tank top off. Let him know.
Look, man.
Let him know.
Hold on. What this is on the camera. Hold on.
So you can sit right there. So now, so do he have? Do he have? This motherfucker got one can. He ain't got six pack. He got one can.
Look at my chest.
These, I'm dealing with a leader. Look, I'm gonna show them what this really about.
See my chest moving?
They call me the landlord. I'm gonna go do my debut.
Look at my chest.
They call me the landlord. What's your chest? Where's your chest at?
You don't see a woman?
I'm gonna just have a stroke. You all right? Check your paws. Look, you have a stroke. Oh, that's the first sign.
Oh, your hands so cold.
That's cold as shit here.
I thought you was a dead body. I was looking for the tag on your toe.
That's funny as shit. All right. We done did good today. We have professionals in the house.
We gotta find... Where can people find John?
Yeah, your social media, your plug.
Snapchat, Chat Finesse. Instagram, This Is Finesse.
Chat Finesse, This Is Finesse.
I'm not following this yet. I don't want to see it.
Snapchat, Powerful Peace, Instagram, Powerful Peace.
Powerful Peace?
Like the...
Powerful.
Piece. Yeah, Powerful Peace. Not like chess piece. Like the white chess piece. Yeah.
War Peace?
No, P-I-E-C-E.
Oh, peace. Like a piece of cake.
Right.
Powerful Peace. She's a powerful piece. Snapchat and Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Powerful Peace.
Chat Finesse.
Chat Finesse.
And This Is Finesse.
And This Is Finesse. Look them up Instagram, chat, Snapchat. Follow them. Find out where they're going to be at. She's rarely out. She send people out now. She got home. She's a business mind. But the titties is banging. You seen the ass still popping.
Yeah. It's still on my shirt. I ain't washing my shirt. I ain't never washing this shirt.
Yeah.
Have
you ever been asked to do porn?
Well, I hear it all the time that I do it already, and
no, you don't.
I don't.
You don't.
Yeah. I don't.
That can change. When this camera go off.
And come back on.
And come back on.
And
with different circumstances.
My shirt is up like this. So, anyway. does aggressive sex excite you?
Yes.
Like a real, you like to be... Grab like this.
Not so hard.
Not real hard.
A bit of choking is okay. Talk dirty to me.
Smack the ass.
Let me know you're into it.
Cause somebody call you.
I like
do it, bitch. Do it.
No.
Can't call you this.
No.
That's a turn on.
That's not for me. I like to grab my ass.
You like to like a squoze.
And hold it. Yeah.
You gotta squozed.
You gotta have a good grip. Like what?
You like it's like the squoze. Squeeze, squoze, squeeze it. You give a fuck.
Squirrels.
Grab the ass. It'd be
squirrels.
Squirrels. You ever had a girl try to put her finger in your butt? They try anything with you.
Kanye.
They go, I got stuff for us, honey. Ying! Ying! Just lay down!
Has your wife tried that with you?
We get down, but we gonna start doing the shit we just seen. I'm going that this weekend while we in New York and Martha's Vineyard kicking it. I'm gonna go, this is our time. I'm gonna show you.
Do you feel like you taught the people enough? Because if not, we can.
They got
you
enough.
You already told me you don't have no money.
No, you didn't hear me.
I heard you.
No.
I hear that clear.
I said my money's not funny. I said this ain't a gag.
He got money. He just wear them jeans all the time. The jeans are reversible. He flip them over, it's movie tickets on the inside. You can go see Tarzan, all kind of shit in these jeans, but you can pick the ticket. This motherfucker got money. He just trying to hide it. He got money. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we had a good show. This is The Other Truth. Lance Woods, right here, my partner, Tony Roberts. We about to get busy.
Follow Tony T. Roberts, Lance Woods, Sexual Charcoal.
Put that T in the middle.
Yeah.
You go with Tony Roberts, you're going to get an old white dude. You do it all the time. Tony T. Roberts, at Tony T. Roberts. Follow me.
Lance Sexual Woods. Charcoal, Snapchat, Instagram, Lance Woods, Powerful Peace,
Sexual Chat Charcoal. Mike. Why do you keep telling people that?
Chat Finesse. And this is Finesse.
This is Finesse.
Yeah.
Powerful Peace. You're a powerful peace. Really. You go to the gym?
Mm-hmm.
You go?
I think I've seen that at the gym before. What gym you go to? Oh, you can't. You don't want to say that. Yeah.
Cal Fit. I don't care. Okay. They already go there.
Could you make love to somebody you can't kiss? Can you fuck somebody you can't kiss? I mean, not just make love. Just we're going to go away real with it. Can you have sex with somebody that you can't kiss? Mm-hmm. I can't. Mm-hmm. That's my vice. I'm like the perfect kisser. Don't look at me, motherfucker. Talking to her. And them. So my wife, if I can't kiss you, I can't get down. It ain't going to be like I want it to be. It ain't going to be like right. You want it to be.
Yeah.
No, it ain't. So some people just don't have to kiss, you know, and not me. What about you?
Yeah, I got to kiss. No. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not he said
gonna,
no, yeah.
I'm not even going to waste my time having sex if I don't enjoy it.
Right.
He said that in Spanish. I don't know how sex, oh, no, oh, joy, and oh, no.
Oh, no, time mismo, no.
And no,
tell the mundo.
Mucho, oh, no.
Yo quiero Taco Bell.
Yeah. And I can still hang out with the person and be friends with them.
Yeah.
And not have sex.
I can't hang out with you every time I see you, I really want to have sex with you real bad. I can't just be hanging out with you. And, yeah, girl talking. You confide in me. I'm like, yeah, okay. That's enough of that. Sit on this. Something. Because I got to kill the curiosity. If I'm curious about it and I hit it, then we can start kicking it. I ain't got to hit it again. I'm tired of looking at it like, just got to be... But you know what?
What if it's bad for the woman? How are we supposed to just...
Let me tell you about a lot of women. This is how women are today. You want to get it, you date her, you talk to her, it take you a month, 2 months. Some women will make you wait and you date, meet the 90 people.
90 days.
90 days. And then you wait and wait and you're obedient, you're patient, you're a gentleman, and you can't wait to get it. But and then when they make you wait, when you do get it, when you finally get it, woo! That shit be garbage. You be like, fuck this. I can't believe this shit.
Nice to everybody.
And see, on the other flip side of that, is we've hung out with you for 90 days. Now we like you, and it's garbage, but we still like you, and we'll tolerate it.
Nah, y'all eventually will.
I'm going to call you back and have another chick with us to help you if you're garbage like that. Cause I ain't going to say I'm the best, but I'm on the team.
I got a jersey. It's a fishnet jersey, but yeah. You got a jersey.
It's a fishnet. It's a hot-to-top type thing. It's a cut-off 1975 basketball jersey.
I think I'm doing all right in that department.
I think you're doing all right. I can't see you doing... You can lay unconscious. They don't know I'm there. And I'm fucking loving it. I'm going to just tell you how it was. But you missed. You missed these tears. Ladies and gentlemen, we got to get out of here. We love y'all. Tune in next week when we're going to have the mayor lap dancing the fire chief.